The media is losing the narrative and is losing their power of their propaganda machine. And now they are losing their minds. Rosie the Riveter here, dropping more truth bombs to destroy fake news and propaganda. Don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell to get new videos when they are uploaded. Now, let's get into today's riveting topic. Joe Scarborough recently melted down in his morning show in a rant against President Donald Trump, claiming if Trump is reelected, he will finally become the tyrant the news media has insisted he is for the last 7 years. Scarborough actually dismissed the argument that even though Trump did not do these things in his first term, he must be stopped because he will do them in his next term. Take a listen.
I have a responsibility to tune out the voices of the haters, of the people that are constantly double
shilling
and triple checking and shilling for him and suggesting
Sick.
That somehow they're being biased, bending over backwards, treating him like a normal candidate. He's not a normal candidate. He is running to end American democracy as we know it. He's an authoritarian who a court in Colorado 2 days ago ruled that he led an insurrection against the United States government. He's charged with leading schemes to help overthrow the United States government. So if they want to frame it that way, that's fine. If you want to be fair, then you will frame this as Joe Biden being the candidate that supports American democracy and Donald Trump, a candidate who supports a new form of government here that's authoritarian. It's really that simple. And by the way, Reverend Allen, people go, oh, you can't compare him to past Nazi leaders. You can't compare him to this past Nazi leader or that past fascist leader because he hasn't done that. Well, what hasn't he done? He hasn't done the things that the American judicial system did not allow him to do last time, but may very well allow him to do this time, or a judicial system that will be ignored by Donald Trump and ran over by Donald Trump to create the greatest constitutional crisis of our lifetimes. Just because he hasn't done it yet doesn't mean he won't do it when he gets a chance to do it. And if he is voted into office, then a lot of these people that are talking about literal or figurative or whatever the hell they're saying, you're going to look like idiots. Because he will do, he will get away with, he will imprison, he will execute whoever he's allowed to imprison, execute, drive from the country. Just look at his past. It's not really hard to read. The only thing that stood between him and the destruction of American democracy was the federal judiciary.
Let's go through some of the accusations, shall we? Scarborough says Trump is running to end American democracy as we know it. Well, Joe, the way the American people know American democracy is how it was designed, which is a constitutional republic. Several of my previous videos address what Democrats and the media mean when they talk about democracy, and
you keep using the word. I don't think it means what you think it means.
Check out my videos in the description box below for more information on that. But to answer your accusation, Joe, yes, Trump is looking to destroy democracy as you know it. How? By ousting bought and paid for politicians and media mockingbirds, eradicating backroom deals where the will and especially the best interest of the American people are completely ignored, eliminate the unconstitutional hold the government has over social and legacy media, where dissenters are censored and propaganda is king, and taking control away from corrupt politicians selling us out to China, Ukraine, Russia, Israel, Hamas, and the New World Order, and putting the power of the government back into the hands of the American people where it belongs. The fact Scarborough finds this a problem tells you all you need to know about him and the rest of the media. Scarborough argues Trump has been charged with leading schemes to overthrow the government. The recently released January 6th tapes prove this accusation is a complete and total lie perpetrated by entities such as Joe Scarborough and the MSNBC. Could Scarborough be getting a little worried the truth of the mainstream media's fake January 6th narrative is exploding in his face? He accuses Trump of supporting a new form of government, which Scarborough claims is authoritarianism. Let's look at how Trump describes this new form of government in his first inauguration address.
Today's ceremony, however, has very special meaning, because today we are not merely transferring power from one administration to another, or from one party to another, but we are transferring power from Washington, D.C., and giving it back to you, the people. For too long, a small group in our nation's capital has reaped the rewards of government while the people have borne the cost. Washington flourished, but the people did not share in its wealth. Politicians prospered, but the jobs left and the factories closed. The establishment protected itself, but not the citizens of our country. Their victories have not been your victories. Their triumphs have not been your triumphs. And while they celebrated in our nation's capital, there was little to celebrate for struggling families all across our land.
Huh. Hey, Joe. That actually sounds like the Constitutional Republic the founders gave us 250 years ago. Finally, Scarborough claims Trump didn't do the things he's accusing Trump of wanting to do because the judicial system stopped him. In a second term, Scarborough believes Trump will give the courts the middle finger and do what he wants. Hey, Joe, if that is really a concern for you, you don't have to wait for Trump's administration to call it out. We've been living under Biden's complete disregard for the law and the judicial system for 3 years now. This is just a tiny sample of Biden's authoritarian administration and constant disregard for the Constitution, the American people, and the courts.
Thank you.
But wait, it gets even more tyrannical.
The situation with air marshals, are they still getting sent down to the southern border?
Carly, nothing has changed since we've been fighting this for almost 2 years. The air marshals are still down on the border. We are not flying right now. We just received an email last week that the resources are depleted as far as our flying air marshals. So we are ushering in illegal immigrants on the border and leaving the traveling public unsafe. Carly, we're not flying right now. The only missions that we're doing are quiet skies missions, and those are missions that are following the January 2021 people. So we're either on the border for illegal immigrants or we're following folks from January 2021. We're not doing our regular missions where we're out there looking for the bad guys. So right now on most flights, you're not going to have air marshals.
What do you mean by that you're following January 2021 people? What does that mean?
That means our primary mission is a little group called Quiet Skies. It's a mission called Quiet Skies that we're following people that flew into the National Capital Region in January 2021. You did not have to go to the Capitol or the rally, and you've been put on a specific list that TSA now has assigned air marshals to follow these people who have not had any type of criminal investigation. They haven't committed a crime, but yet 3 years later, we're following the same individuals day in and day out.
So you're saying that air marshals are now following people that were at the Capitol on January 6th, and they're not tracking terrorists at all?
Well, they didn't even have to be at the Capitol, Carly. They could have just flown into the National Capital Region. So if anybody was there for a job interview, to visit family, we even had a gentleman that was there for a funeral. They put on this domestic terrorist list just because of their geographic location to Washington, D.C. So these people did not even commit a crime. They weren't even at the Capitol.
What?
Did you catch that, Patriots? Our air marshals, who are supposed to be protecting us from terrorists, are being reassigned to help process illegals flooding our border and follow people who are in D.C. on January 6th, including those who weren't even there at the Capitol. Why? So they can harass and imprison those political enemies, and you know who's allowing it to happen? The corrupt D.C. courts, including the same judge who is overseeing Trump's trial. Can we say projection, Joe? Our federal law enforcement is so obsessed with J6ers that have absolutely no criminal records. The FBI paused their investigation into pedophiles to focus on them. As a result, more children have been abused because Biden's FBI and DOJ thought people walking around the Capitol were more of a threat than the perverts preying on our children. Where is your rant on that, Joe? So here's my two cents on why Scarborough is melting down, Patriots. Joe sees the writing on the wall. Trump is exposing all the corruption, all the unconstitutional, illegal, and frankly, evil acts these activists parading as journalists have engaged in and are covering up. I believe Scarborough knows when Trump returns to the White House, their reign of propaganda is over. And when those who engaged in crimes such as fraud, deception, and treason are exposed, the Americans will demand these people be held accountable. The politicians and journalists have been in bed with each other, literally covering up each other's illegal activities, including enriching family members to hide their bribes and paybacks. The media knows what's going on, and they've lied about it all. Can we say Hunter Biden? The media only cares about family members if they are connected to Trump. Did you know Mika's dad was a former U.S. National Security Advisor serving under multiple administrations? His policies put guns in the hands of Islamic extremists, resulting in the formation of Al-Qaeda, which led to the Taliban. Brzezinski spent decades sending our money to Islamic extremists, keeping that part of the world in constant war. As reported in Global Research, Brzezinski knew exactly what he was doing. The Soviets were being bogged down in Afghanistan for approximately 10 years, fighting an endless supply of American-supplied weapons and trained fighters. At the time, the media even went so far as to laud Osama bin Laden, one of the most influential figures in Brzezinski's covert operation. We all know how that story ended. Remember when Trump said this?
But China's trying to take over the world, and they're doing it. They're in Cuba now. They're taking over, essentially, quietly, militarily, they're taking over Cuba, but they're taking over South America. They're taking over the Panama Canal. How about the Panama Canal? We lost 36,000 lives, the mosquito. We lost 36,000 lives building the Panama Canal. It was stupidly sold for $1 to Panama. Okay, how about that one? It was done by, during the Carter administration, it was sold for $1, and now China is taking it over.
Can you guess who helped broker that deal? Medium fact-checked Trump's statement, and though the actual price was never disclosed, they admitted the deal was worse than Trump described, as we actually paid Panama in addition to basically gifting the canal to them. Now, China, in essence, controls it. Do you really think Mika and Joe are going to honestly report on things in any way related to or resulting from her father's actions? There was a time Joe and Mika were very friendly with Trump. Remember, Mika liked Trump before she hated him.
What did you learn, Mika?
I learned that Donald Trump, again,
he's a nice guy.
He's a really nice guy.
Yeah.
And he gave a wonderful donation to the Global Medical Relief Fund. My daughter's having a fundraiser. Yep. She worked there. Thank you.
Is it possible Scarborough is a little concerned about his future? Is he terrified he's going to prison? Not because Trump's a dictator, but because his actions are about to be revealed to the world. Maybe Joe has a few skeletons he would rather keep hidden, and Trump is threatening that. Seriously, do you still honestly believe the mainstream media is unbiased and uncontrolled by higher powers? Remember when Mika said this?
He could have undermined the messaging so much that he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
Yeah.
If the media can't control the narrative, they lose their power. If they lose their power, they can't manipulate the people. If they can't manipulate the people are truly free. And that, my friends, is why Scarborough is terrified of Trump returning to the White House. I'm Rosie the Riveter, and that's my two cents. But what do you think? Leave your comments down below. If you enjoy my content, please consider supporting my work on Patreon. You can find all my videos and my blog, Liberating Letters, at thefactspaper.com. You can also start your own research on the Facts Paper by exploring the thousands of links to articles I have, including those noted in my videos, Sharing the Truth Fake News Propagandists Won't. Investigate and discover the truth for yourself.